Happy Thrive and Shine, Fabulous Friday, everyone. So I know it's been a while since I've come on and shared a video or any inspiration with you all. And the day I actually choose to come up and share something, I barely have a voice, but that's okay. We will persevere through it. So today I wanted to come on for two reasons. One, to say hello. No, well, not one, but before, once again, hello to everyone. But the first reason I wanted to come on is to share my good news. So after months of going back and forth with this, and having to postpone the original date, I will hopefully be taping with Dr. April on her show On Your Ish. It's a show on Mogul TV. I am going to be a guest where I will be sharing some empowering, inspirational words, well, words of encouragement, as well as sharing some news in regards to the release of my book that I am that I will be releasing. So I'm definitely happy about that. Two, I came on because this morning as I went online, someone had posted Stacy Rush, I just want to say thank you. She had posted this quote. She had posted something that said how tired she was. But what caught my attention, she said, "My goals are bigger than my feelings." And I thought, like, wow, that is really powerful. Good morning, Elijah. That's really powerful. And I just began to think on that thing. And I was like, wow, my goals are bigger than my feelings. And I had to kind of reflect on that with me, because I'm not gonna lie, sometimes my feelings get in the way and I don't want to do certain things. And I had to check myself and said, and think about that, my goals are bigger than my feelings. And so what does that mean? What you have planned, what you want to accomplish has to be bigger than how you feel. Because emotions and feelings will get in the way of life, and feelings will stagnate you. Feelings will cause you to procrastinate. Feelings will cause you to be delayed. Feelings will cause you to miss out on opportunities. And I was like, wow. And we wonder why so many times we have goals that we never accomplish completely or entirely. And we always figure, like, why am I stuck? Why am I stuck? Because we've allowed our feelings to get in the way. And what do I mean by that? We allow our feelings to get in the way when we know we should be doing certain things to bring us closer to that goal, to accomplish that goal. Say, for instance, you're supposed to be writing your business plan, and you decide, you know what, it's been a long day, I'm tired, I don't want to do any writing today. And so what we do, we'll sit there and we'll watch television, we'll sit there and just be brainless and mindless throughout the weekend, because we feel like we feel like we're tired, our body is tired, our body needs rest. And yes, that's true, but we have to be willing to put our feelings aside and go deeper and stay disciplined into what we want to accomplish. Discipline over feelings, goals over feelings. Discipline, we have to be more disciplined over our feelings and be more disciplined to be willing to commitment over feelings. And so I'm not gonna make this long, I'm already at 4 minutes. I just want to say, hey, if you are out there and you're trying to accomplish any types of goals, you're trying to make certain things happen in your life, remember this: allow your goals to be bigger and greater than your feelings. Don't allow your feelings to get in the way of what you're trying to accomplish, of your purpose, of your destiny. Don't allow your feelings to cause you to procrastinate, to cause you to be stagnant, or to cause you to second guess yourself, because things aren't happening when you want them to happen or as you think they should happen. So this morning, be encouraged, stay disciplined, stay focused, and allow your goals to be bigger and greater than your feelings. Peace and blessings, everyone. Have a wonderful and blessed, fabulous day. And we will see you all again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.